we lived in the same area and we worked at the same place, and yeah, we just kind of started talking about bands we liked, and we had like similar tastes, I think. So then we just started playing guitar together, and then one day he said, oh, my friend Dave, you know, has a drum kit, and he invited him over to Patrick's house, where I'd been hanging out a lot, and we just set up at Patrick's house, and we just played songs like Kinks and Nirvana, and we had no really intent to start a band. It was just something for fun, because we were all just getting into music, and then we just kind of kept doing it because it was fun. And then after like a few months, I just remember like thinking, oh, I wonder if I could write, you know, a song of my own. I'm feeling happy, so highly evolved. My time's a riddle that will never be solved. Dreaming for something, reaching for something. Just waiting for the sun to carry me in. If you feel love, you can buy. Highly Evolved is the title of the album, and remember I came up with those two words, I think, or it was about people in general, or you know, all the good and the bad things, the technology, whatever. And
Highly Evolved! Everybody ready? Anybody not ready? Okay, and say 10, play back!
Back in Australia, I guess I wasn't the most, like, social butterfly. So that was, like, that's where I guess a lot of the music came from. I had this vision, all these kind of things that got me into music, and then all these things I wanted to do, and all these things that suited my personality, and just kind of, like, that's what it meant to me, like, the quantity is as important as the quality, and the quality and vice versa, like that. Kept playing and writing and stuff like that, and we saw this thing, like these possibilities. It's limitless. Yeah, I just wanted to, focusing all my, my energy into the band. Going on stage every night, it's, because it's another world up there. When I come off stage, it's like, where the f*** have I been? Like, because, you're in the sound world. Physically, it's inside you when you play on stage, so you can feel the bass in you. Chest and all that stuff, so it's a very powerful thing. I mean, yeah, we never did a lot of live stuff before. We made the album before we made the album, we did some of it. We played maybe like 50 shows in Australia, and but you know, we did a lot of work within the songwriting and so, and the recordings. We loved recording on 4 tracks and 8 tracks. We thought it was like exciting. And at that point, when we were in Australia, that was enough for us, like, because we wanted to expand, you know, the catalogue, and we wanted to for it to get better. And so that's what it meant to us, that, you know, being in a band and creating, like, and giving something back and making something real and of our own will, instead of, like, going, you know, we want to rule the world, we want to go and play in front of 1 million people, because it's not like that. That is all well and good and fun, and it's part of it, but for us, it's more being the sound world. We're very song orientated as a band, and it's important to us, you know. We're not just looking for one sound, or we want to do, you know, anything, because that's what attracted us about being artists, about playing in a band, because it's something which is very free, and you get the opportunity to be creative, and it just so happens that we just did a lot of songwriting in the underground, and we didn't really care about what anybody else thought, because we were just into our own thing.
It's not over yet. Music Choice will be right back with more from The Vines.
Music Choice is commercial-free CD panels that...
There's definitely room for it. Definitely after all that, like, that all that pop group crap.